think that music in schools is so important because it allows that other half of the academic brain to engage, but it encompasses so much. It's encompassing the whole creative child.
Music is at the heart of everything in society. Historically, it's been able to celebrate weddings, or it celebrates friendship, or it celebrates love. And as time has evolved, it's become a way of people to express themselves.
We are making connections across time periods. We're making connections across cultures. We're making connections across our classrooms with our students. It is all about experiencing that emotional education and input. And it is so important for us to be able to feel that ourselves, empathy, but also to be able to put ourselves into that and go out to others as well.
It's a time for them to express themselves. It's a safe space for them to make mistakes. It's a great place to learn things. And it's just a fabulous environment that's relaxing. Sometimes it's stressful, yes, but most of the time it's relaxing, and it allows the students just to express themselves and to kind of get out their emotions a little bit. And I think it's a really, really important place for our students to come and be a part of.
Especially at the middle level, where these kids find their people. We hear it with the musical, especially. We hear the kids who say they found their family and they find their people and they become lifelong friends. They build those relationships. They find their identities. They find all of those things that they've been looking for in the music programs. In first grade, we really, really, really focus on steady beat and rhythms and understanding the difference between steady beat and rhythm. Then we begin to add in pitch intervals, and we have them repeat the same pitch intervals over and over and over again because we want them to get it into their body. And we use multimodal, so while they're singing, they're going to be using hands, which is going to connect to their brain, which connects to the voice production, so that you have all of this muscle memory acting up. So they may just be singing "So Me," and they may have to sing this "So Me" pattern for, you know, I would say probably 2 to 3 months. And then we add in another pitch, and now they can hear that difference. And as they progress to second grade, we add in a third pitch of do. And as they keep going from grade level to grade level, there are these new pitch relationships that are added. They're learning new rhythms as well. So in first grade, we focus on quarter notes and eighth notes, or one sound on the beat, two sounds on the beat. And then we're also discovering that music is made of sound and silence, so we add in the quarter rest. In second grade, we reinforce all of that at the beginning of the school year, and then halfway through, we start to introduce tie and then half note. And then we can also add in the half rest. And so we're taking it in what many may think of as like a slower progress, but it's still giving them that opportunity to experience it with all of the different songs and poems that we use. And they're just really internalizing each rhythm and each concept. So we take it at a slow pace, but every student's able to learn it at that pace. Arts Alive is a program that takes music, acting, and movement combined together to tell stories. So it's based in the music curriculum because it supplements what we're learning in music class. For first grade, many of the students see that there's not a lot of difference between music and Arts Alive because we're still building the foundation of their musical concepts. As we get a little bit farther along at the end of the first grade year and into second grade, students are now pantomiming more, and they're developing spoken expression. So they're learning how to project their voices. They're learning how to add emotional expression into their voice production, as well as look at a character and figure out what emotions they're going through as well. I love the fact that there is also a connection between the English language arts programs. So we're supplementing that as well, and it's giving the students a way to create stories and understand that music can be added into it, that they can create movement for their characters, or maybe they create dances for their characters.
We continue on with the two classes that happen at the elementary school, which would be general music, although I just love to call it music awesomeness, and then Arts Alive. And in our programs and these classrooms, we do more of the creativity of building upon those basic building blocks. So at the elementary school, they're learning the basic language skills of music. As they come here, we're learning more of the language skills, but then they are creating their own music, their own activities. They are discovering it for themselves because, you know, most people think that music is talent, and it's not really. It's a language, and it is accessible to all children. We just have to show them and help them to discover where they can find that connection. We also allow them at this school to discover different instruments. So we play the recorder in the general music classroom. And then they also have the opportunities in third grade to take orchestra, which are beginning orchestra instruments of violin, viola, cello, and bass. And then our band program begins in fourth grade with clarinet, saxophone, percussion, trumpet, trombone, and I'm missing one, flute. And so they get a chance to discover what works for them and to try different things and find what part of music connects with them. Some extracurricular activities for the students. They have fourth grade performing arts club where they put together a musical and the fourth grade students get their first chance of singing in an ensemble choral style. The third graders have a beginner's concert that happens in the fall and the spring for orchestra. And then they also have a fourth grade after school orchestra and a fifth grade after school orchestra. Our band students also have a beginner's band that performs in the fall and in the spring. They also, there's a fifth grade after school band. And then there's also fifth grade choir and orff ensemble, which is a choral experience. The kids sing choral songs, but they also do Orffschulwerk approach with barred instruments and movement and recorder playing and unpitched percussion instruments. So the students have the opportunities to join those things as well.
Here at South Fayette Middle School, the students have musical offerings in general music, orchestra, band, and choir. So general music is offered to students who are not in an ensemble. Orchestra, obviously, is our strengths program. We have instrumental music available with orchestra and band. And then we have choir available for students who want to sing. We also have a chamber choir program that I run for kids who are either in gen music or in an instrumental ensemble who still want an opportunity to sing but can't schedule it as part of their regular scheduled curriculum. I love that at middle schools, students still have to take a music class and it's still required. A lot of places around the state don't require music after they leave the elementary.
So
So once they come to the high school, they have lots of options. There is our marching band, a concert band. We have a jazz ensemble that meets after school. So if they play any of those kinds of instruments, they have all those choices. If they are a string player, we have an orchestra class. We also have chamber strings after school for kids who just can't schedule it. We have concert choir for all students who love to sing, and then we have an audition choir called Vocal Point, and so those students can be a part of that. Within our bands, we have concert band for all students who want to play an instrument, plus we also have the wind ensemble, which is an auditioned ensemble. We offer digital piano and musicianship, and there's a level one and a level two. And then there's an AP music theory course that's offered for students who have been involved in an ensemble for a couple of years, or who have been playing piano for a number of years, or have taken those digital piano and musicianship courses.
I'm so blessed to work at a district that truly, truly, truly appreciates and values that every student can be musical. And even if they are not going on to be musicians, they're still going to be audience members. And we have this wonderful support from administration that was definitely showcased by what went into making sure that our high school students were able to have a musical.
I have to say that our mission statement says it all. In most districts, you don't see the arts being placed right into the mission statement. And here at South Fayette, we are passionate, and so passionate about it that it is literally in our drive to what we do. It is at the forefront of our thoughts and our feelings. Our buildings have been built around what we do in our classrooms and that experience for the children.
The support that we have here is absolutely remarkable. Whenever people say that South Fayette supports the arts, academics, and athletics, it is absolutely true. Whenever you look around, I've taught in several different districts, and at a concert, when I look out and I see administrators, school board members, community members, parents, and other students all sitting there, the support is remarkable.
I feel like our administration is super supportive of us. I feel like the other teachers are very, very supportive. We just recently put on our spring musical, and I saw so many of our faculty attending the musical, and that really, really felt good to see those people there supporting our students.
It's really, really, really remarkable to see that everybody in this community and on this campus are truly believers in music education.